You're watching Turner Classic Movies.
Hello, I'm Robert Osborne. That's pretty neat, right? Tonight, we're taking a look at one of America's great starlets from the 1930s, Lulu Diamonds. Paramount had found a gold mine in Mae West, so RKO was eager to find their own bombastic blonde. And they found it in vaudeville's Lulu Diamond. Known for her blatant sexuality and her hugely popular catchphrase, "Why don't you come upstairs and see me up there sometime?" Here's a scene from her first motion picture, set in New York's famous Plaza Hotel, entitled Do Not Not Disturb.
Oh, howdy, boys. They call me Firecracker. I guess it's cold when I talk with my slacks. I go pow. Oh, calm down, boys. I'm just getting started.
Oh, Lulu, you're the cat's pajamas.
Oh, why does he have to be in pajamas? Is he small down there? Whoa.
Oh, Lulu, you're too much.
Oh, there's no such thing as too much, unless we're talking about vegetables.
Oh, Lulu, marry me, please.
I got a better idea. Why don't you come upstairs and see me up there sometimes?
Oh, sure.
Lulu? Ginger. Oh, Lulu. Don't look too hard, or you just might...
Well, if you're a film buff like me, you probably noticed that Lulu slipped a little bit. Did you catch it? Every important bone in her body was shattered. But the studio was none too happy to have their highest grossing star out of commission, and they forced her and her catchphrase to return to the set to begin filming a sequel. Was it too soon?
Look, boys, Lulu's back.
Did you miss me? Because I didn't. Whoa.
Oh, Lulu, run away with me.
The only thing I ever run to was the bathroom.
Lulu, why do you have to make things so complicated?
The only thing complicated is vegetables. Now, I got an idea. Why don't you come upstairs and see me up there sometimes?
And that was the best of 50 takes. And it should have been another trip to the hospital for Lulu, but the studio had already committed her to her next film. Armed with just a heating pad and a fistful of cat tranquilizers she stole from a jazz man, Lulu went back to work.
Look, everybody, it's Lulu.
You're darn tootin', it's Lulu. Oh, I needed that.
Oh, Lulu, you're making me crazy.
The only thing I make is mistakes. And you seem like you might have a big one.
Oh, yeah, hubba, hubba.
Why don't you come upstairs and see me up there sometimes?
Lulu, why don't we just do it down here? Yeah, Lulu, we can just put down some towels.
Don't be silly. We can go up the monkey way.
What's that?
Oh, you'll see and you'll hear it.
Hubba, 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 oh, yowza, well, I'm not so...
Doesn't seem very logical.
Yeah, there she goes.
Oh, no, Lulu.
Oh, bananas and cheddar.
Well, believe it or not, Lulu Diamonds won an Oscar for that performance. But she was too afraid to go up to the steps and accept it. So David Niven did so on her behalf and then pretended he lost it. Classic Niven. Finally, someone at the studio, probably an intern, decided to start Lulu at the top of the stairs.
Howdy, boys. Why don't you come up and see me up here where I already am, thank goodness.
What a name! You're the best, Lulu! You're the best!
Hey, Lulu! Catch!
Oh!
Oh, boy. Oh, I tell you what. Sadly, that was Lulu's last film. She died as she lived, on all fours with three closeted gay actors staring at her butt. For Turner Movie Classics, I'm Robert Osborne, and I'm gonna go home now and not go to the bar. I'm not. Not tonight. The bar is not happening for this guy. I gotta cool with the booze, otherwise I'm gonna lose it all. Thanks again for watching. I'm Robert Osborne, and seriously, don't let me go to the bar. I'm gonna have one. I'm gonna have a quick one.